What's up, Bargain Family? Welcome back to my channel. So today for you guys, I have some Dollar Tree gift basket ideas. This is going to be different than my Dollar Tree gift idea video, which I hope to upload next week. This is just getting a basket, putting items inside of that basket. I'm going to share with you guys how to make it look a little bit more high-end and how to decorate your baskets and make them more unique. I'm sure a lot of you guys have heard recently that Dollar Tree is going to be going up to $1.25 starting in some states this year and then rolling out to the rest next year. And I want to know, is that going to affect you from buying things at Dollar Tree? If you're no longer going to shop there, if you'll continue to shop there, I'll continue to shop there, but I know I'm going to have to keep my eyes open for where the actual deals are. So let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you like it, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed yet to my YouTube channel, make sure you subscribe. I upload lots of Dollar Tree related content on this channel. And if that sounds like something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe because I'm so close to hitting a million subscribers. With that being said, let's begin the video.
I find myself sharing this gift basket idea every single year because it's perfect for any age and it's so easy to do. So you're going to pick up one of the bigger popcorn containers from Dollar Tree and put some decorative filler inside of it. The decorative shred I got from Dollar Tree, and there's a bunch of different colors to choose from. I went with red. Dollar carries this 2 for $1 two-pack of the popcorn containers I also put inside. Of course, you're going to need some popcorn for this. I got it from Dollar Tree, and candy. What is a movie night without candy? Dollar Tree carries a bunch of candy to choose from. So many movie boxes. Let me know your favorite movie candy down in the comments below. Mine's are snow caps, and I don't really know why. I think I like the crunch of the sprinkles. Right now at Dollar Tree, you can find these movie clapboards, and they're a perfect addition to your basket to help customize it. So I went ahead and I just wrote whatever the heck I wrote on this. You can put the name of the person you're giving it to, the last name of the family you're giving it to, a specific Christmas movie, and throw the DVD inside. You can throw in a movie theater gift card. It's completely up to you. So this is how this basket turned out. I love it. And here's a tip. If you want your products inside of your baskets to stay put exactly where you put them, use glue dots. Now, Dollar Tree carries balloon glue dots that I prefer more than the craft section ones. And you just place them wherever you want two things to hold. For instance, these candies, I wanted them to stay in place. So I take my glue dot, I put it on the back of one candy and attach it to the other candy. Now, what happens is it keeps the candies together, but it doesn't leave behind a bunch of residue and it's easy to take off of the product. You also use the glue dots to create height in your basket. I wanted these M&Ms to be higher up, so I went ahead and I used glue dots to make that happen. If you're looking for more inexpensive gift baskets other than the ones that Dollar Tree carries, go to your local thrift store. You can find inexpensive ones there. I'm going to be using a gift basket I got for $1 at Goodwill. Now I'm going to place some brownie mix that I got from Dollar Tree in my basket, and then I'm going to use these Betty Crocker utensils and place them inside of an oven mitt, all from Dollar Tree. I throw another mix in my basket, and right now Dollar Tree is carrying a bunch of cake decorating utensils, so I added a few of them inside of this basket. Another thing new to Dollar Tree are colored sugar crystals. I added two of those to my basket and threw in these cake spatulas. Now I throw in some plastic cookie cutters I got at Dollar Tree. They come in a 6-pack, and this small little gumball machine. I thought it was a cute little addition. I then take a tag that I got from Dollar Tree and write, "We wish you a Merry Christmas" on the tag. If you're wondering why I start with the middle letters for some of the words, it's so that I get everything perfectly centered. Lots of times when I just start with the first letter of the word and just write it out normally, I realize afterward it's not centered. So I start with the middle letters and get that perfect center. Now I'm going to use a zip tie to tie this tinsel candy cane that I got from Dollar Tree and this little red whisk. I wrap it through my basket and then tie those in place, and then I add my tag. How nice did this basket turn out? And I think the tag was the perfect addition to this. The basket we'll be using for this gift basket is a mixing bowl from Dollar Tree, and I filled it up with some white decorative shred. Now I place a pot holder inside of this basket and some chocolate chip mix. I'm throwing in these measuring spoons and cups that I got from Dollar Tree. They're some of my favorite measuring spoons and cups because they're so inexpensive and they get the job done. Since the basket has a cookie theme, I thought this gingerbread hand soap from Dollar Tree paired well with it. I then put some of those cookie cutters from Dollar Tree inside of this basket. On the front of my mixing bowl, I placed one of these vinyls I cut out using my Cricut. It says Baking Spirits Bright. If you do not have a Cricut, you can get the tags from Dollar Tree and write it out. I got this curled ribbon from Dollar Tree. It actually comes in a 3-pack. I take one of the ribbons, cut it down the center, and use pieces of it to fill the inside of my basket at the very top so that it's just coming out of the basket. This is definitely one of my favorite baskets in this whole video. I got another Goodwill basket for this particular gift basket, and I filled it up with some decorative shred. We're gonna do a hot cocoa themed basket that is really, really nice. So the first thing I throw in this basket is some brownie brittle. I put that in the back, and then Dollar Tree carries some spoons that are edible. So they have these chocolate spoons and peppermint spoons. I went ahead and placed those inside of my basket. Now I got these really pretty glass containers from Dollar Tree, and I'm gonna fill them up with some marshmallows and hot chocolate. The marshmallows I'm placing inside of this glass are dark chocolate covered marshmallows, and they're from the brand Smash Mallow. I got them at Target and they're really, really good. By putting these items inside of glass containers, I feel like they make the basket look more high-end. During this time of the year, Dollar Tree carries the cutest coffee mugs. I'm going to be attaching two of those to the top of the glasses. To do this, I use some glue tape that I got from Dollar Tree, but I do prefer the glue dots. I was just trying out the glue tape. The glue dots work much easier. I place the mugs on top of the glasses, and that way they don't keep falling out of the basket. Then I'm going to place this tinsel tree that I got from Dollar Tree. I think this is the perfect addition for this particular basket. And then I'm going to add a hot cocoa bomb that I purchased at Dollar Tree. This is another basket that looks super high end to me. I love the way that this one came out. I love this idea. From Dollar Tree, you're gonna pick up some of their balloon sticks, as well as some tape. You can even get the wooden dolls from Dollar Tree, but I prefer the sticks. And you're also gonna pick up some candy. You wanna get variations of candy with the size and width of the packaging. Now what you'll do is you'll flip your candy over and place a couple of sticks on the back of the candy. You'll tape them down using your roll of tape. You'll cut the length off of the sticks so you get different variations of height with the candy. If you're gonna use two sticks, you gotta make sure that you tape the bottom of the sticks so that they don't keep opening on you. Now I'm gonna be using this gift bag box. So basically it's a box that looks like a gift bag. And I'm gonna start placing my candy inside of this box. If you have styrofoam, you can go ahead and place it at the bottom. I'm actually not doing that for this gift basket. I place the taller candies in the back. Usually those are the boxes of candy. And then as I get toward the front of the basket, I do shorter candies. I'm going to be using my glue dots from Dollar Tree so that I can get the candy to stay positioned exactly where I want it to. If I don't use the glue dots in transit, these things will fall over on me and they just won't have that pretty look to them. After I have all my candy placed inside of my box, I take some tissue paper from Dollar Tree and I start to fill the holes inside of the basket. I love the way that this one turned out. This is great for co-workers, for teachers, for friends, anybody who loves candy. Another idea for the candy basket is to use the inflatable decor pieces from Dollar Tree. So I got this cute penguin. It tells you exactly what you're supposed to do on the instructions. This is how it looks inflated. And I'm going to attach this Merry Christmas basket to the balloon by using some glue dots and then attach it to my balloon. Since this is a bigger basket, I needed styrofoam to be placed on the bottom so that it holds the candy upright. So I'm using the styrofoam circles that I got from Dollar Tree. I prefer squares, but I only had circles on hand, so I cut them up and put them in the basket. I then just add my candy and my tissue paper. So the exact same thing that we did before, but this is just a different way of doing it. It's a bigger way and, in my opinion, a cuter way. Now for this gift basket, the basket is going to be this little storage box that I got from Dollar Tree, and it reminds me of the Caboodles back in the day. If you're my age, you probably know what I'm talking about. In this basket, I'm going to place some makeup. Now Dollar Tree carries a bunch of different brands. If you can find hard candy, that is a really good brand. You get a lot of bang for your buck. They carry other brands. Sometimes they have Revlon. Sometimes they have CoverGirl. Just pick some pieces that work for you. I place my makeup inside of the basket. I do use some glue dot to get some of the makeup positioned exactly how I want it to look. Put as much makeup that works within your budget inside of this. If you want to get somebody more expensive makeup, say you're going to go to Sephora or Ulta, this is just a pretty way that you can display it. I'm going to top this off with a bottle brush tree from Dollar Tree, and that's all I did for this basket. You can do the same type of concept with the caboodle, but instead of doing makeup, you can do stuff for nails or a pedicure. So I got these slippers. Now the slippers, they are from Five Below. They're just cuter than anything I could find at Dollar Tree that wasn't Christmas related. So then I bought a bunch of things that would go well with a pedicure. So they got like pedicure sets, manicure sets, some nail polish remover. So I put those inside of the slippers and then placed the slippers in a pink caboodle-like storage thing. I also added a face mask, a little pink Christmas tree. I really like this tree, and a room mist from Dollar Tree. And that's how I did this one. You can get Dollar Tree slippers and do the same thing. I put some socks in this time from Dollar Tree, nail polishes, a cute little chapstick that has like the peanuts on it. And then I added a Christmas tree, and that's how I did these slippers, just with Dollar Tree stuff. We're gonna do a rest and relax basket. So I purchased this gigantic basket a while ago at Walmart. And inside of this, I'm gonna place some white decorative shred. I had to use two packs because this was a bigger basket. Dollar Tree carries these aromatherapy body washes and lotions that look like Bath and Body Works knockoffs. I think they're great for this basket. And I'm going to be using two wine glasses from Dollar Tree and these Martinelli's drinks. They have a bunch of different ones at Dollar Tree right now. I looked for ones that have the white wrap at the top, so they look a little bit more like wine. So I start to put these things inside of my basket. I try to put the taller things toward the back so that the height varies within the basket. I place a couple of these candles inside of my basket. When I was at Dollar Tree, I was looking for candles that have kind of a high-end look to them. I'm also going to be placing some of these almonds. These almonds are really, really good. I put a few of those inside of my basket. And of course, we need some chocolate, so I place two chocolate covered marshmallows in the very front of the basket. Now, when it comes to decorating your basket, look for items at Dollar Tree. I got these cute little miniature trees that really just help decorate the basket and make it look better than just placing things from Dollar Tree just directly in a basket. I filled up my wine glasses with some of that shred to make them really pop. Now, do not skip over the basket bags at Dollar Tree. They carry clear ones, 2 for $1. These things are awesome, and they could fit pretty big baskets inside of the bags. I found them hanging, and what I do is I place my basket inside of the bag, and then I use the little tie that it comes with to tie off the top. Now, this basket was a little too small for the bag, so what I do is I just take some tape and I tape down pieces of the bag so it wraps nicely around my basket. I tied a bow to the top of my basket, and this is how it looks all wrapped up. I had to do some shots also without it wrapped up so that you can see it a little bit more clearly. I did add a bigger bottle brush tree to the back of the basket. We're gonna be using a bucket for this basket, and here's an idea. If you have a basket that is very deep, you can dummy it up with things from Dollar Tree like the stockings or their scarves, and then put some decorative shred over it so it doesn't look too funny. I'm gonna place two wine glasses inside of this bucket and one of those Martinelli drinks. We need some chocolate for this, so I'm gonna place two Godiva chocolates in this. To embellish this, I'm going to use this floral pick that I got from Dollar Tree, and to attach it to the front of the bucket, I'm using my glue dots. Glue dots are awesome. Another simple and unique gift basket. Now we're going to do a charcuterie basket of sorts. I'm going to be using this white basket from Dollar Tree, and I filled it up with some, I would say, brown khaki colored decorative shred. The board for this basket is actually going to be this candy tray that I got from Dollar Tree. And obviously you don't have to go with Dollar Tree food, but because I'm trying to make it a Dollar Tree basket, we're going to add some. So I got this beef jerky from Dollar Tree. The Larissa one is name brand, and so is that Oberto one. I'm going to throw in these almonds, which, as you heard me say earlier, they're actually really good, especially the salsa one. I then threw in this pack of peanuts. I mainly added that one because I needed more height in the back of this, and I ended up using some glue dots to put some of the packs exactly where I wanted them to be. Now, I went to my local grocery store and just picked up two blocks of cheese that were on sale, two for $4. I also threw in this baby Genoa salami that I also got at my local grocery store. You can go to Aldi where they have really inexpensive pricing on charcuterie boards. You know what? That word is so hard for me to pronounce. To decorate this basket, I'm going to place one of these nutcrackers inside of the basket and a couple of these smaller miniature bottle brush trees. And to the front, I'm going to add this Merry Christmas bow that I got from Dollar Tree that comes in a two-pack. That's how this basket turned out. Remember, you can actually go to a grocery store like Aldi and pick up some of these type of items there. And this is how it looks displayed on the tray. It's a cute little Christmas charcuterie board. We can't forget about the kids. Dollar Tree right now has these really pretty buckets. I love them with the little Santa belt. So we're gonna dummy down the bottom of this using some tissue paper from Dollar Tree. I'm going with an elf theme. So Dollar Tree has these elf on the shelf coloring books right now. I placed one of those inside of the basket. Then I'm gonna add two of these elves that I got at Dollar Tree. If you have the elf on the shelf, you can go ahead and place them inside of here. There's a bunch of different elves you can choose from at Dollar Tree. I really like this boy and girl one. Dollar Tree even has children's Christmas books in, so I went ahead and I added the cheerful Santa to this basket. Of course, we need something to color with, so I got these color pencils and crayons that are name brand from Dollar Tree. I did use my glue dots to perfectly place my colored pencils on the book. I'm also going to add these balloon pop things that Dollar Tree carries. So basically, it comes in a bag, you hit it hard, it then blows up, and then a balloon pops out. So I actually opened the pack of four and placed two inside of this. You can always open packs and split it amongst baskets. As always, a perfect gift for most children is candy, so I put some candy inside of the basket. To decorate this basket, I added the elf picks from Dollar Tree and the green ribbon. That's how I did this children elf basket. It's really inexpensive to make, and obviously you can add whatever you want to inside of the basket. We're not forgetting about our infants and toddlers. I'm going to throw a coloring book inside of this basket. I got the Sesame Street one. Every single toddler I know, including my own, loves Elmo. I'm going to throw in some Sesame Street books and this little blanket that is from Dollar Tree. It is thin, but it's perfect to place down when you're trying to do a quick diaper change somewhere. I love the Sesame Street books from Dollar Tree. There's only 5 pages, but they're great for toddlers who have, you know, short attention spans. I read a couple of them to Cooper every single night, and I just switch the books out real fast, and I can keep his attention that way. I'm also going to add some of these Rattle with Rings. I got Elmo and Cookie Monster. Cooper has played with these before. I'm gonna throw in this spoon and fork duo from Dollar Tree and one of these brushes. They have a bunch of different ones with different characters. I throw in this spill-proof sippy cup from Dollar Tree, and there you have a basket that is great for an infant or a younger toddler. This is a basket I would have loved as a child. I was always into toy food, and Dollar Tree has these packs of toy food and kitchen utensils that are so cute. So I'm going to use 3 different ones that I'm going to place inside of this red basket. Now, of course, I'm going to use my glue dots so that I can just get the perfect positioning and display of all of this. I want the packaging to vary in height. The glue dots do come off real easily. So I go ahead and I do that. And then I place 2 of these gingerbread men that I got from Dollar Tree. It's a gingerbread man and a gingerbread woman. And that's it for this basket. This one only cost me $6 to make. And like I said, as a child, I would have loved this. I picked up this basket from Goodwill, and I am going to throw in one of these Buffalo Check Christmas trees from Dollar Tree. Inside of this basket, I'm going to add the scrumptious puff pastries. There was 2 different kinds that I could find at Dollar Tree. And then I'm going to throw in this snowman. I really love these little characters they got this year at Dollar Tree. I found this drizzled popcorn. It's peppermint and crunch. also at Dollar Tree. And then I'm going to throw in these miniature pies. I don't know about you guys. I don't know if you remember these pies. I mean, they still carry them, but I can't remember the name of the brand that was like in a rectangle. It might be Edmonds, but it was like this pie that came in the rectangle one. And I would eat that a lot when I was younger. We're gonna throw a couple of drinks inside of this basket and add a bow. That's how this one came out. This one was really inexpensive to do, and it looks like the stuff that you order offline to be delivered places. Here's another idea for a baking gift basket, but it's a little bit different than the other two. I'm using this Baking Spirits Bright basket that I got from Dollar Tree. I placed some shred inside of there, and then I'm gonna put a few of these Betty Crocker mixes. I did a fudge brownie, a sugar cookie, and a peanut butter cookie. Dollar Tree right now has these really cute mini spatulas that come in a two-pack. I added two of those two-packs. I'm also gonna throw in some of those cake decorating supplies that Dollar Tree carries right now. And this time around for the sprinkles, I'm gonna use these DIY ornaments that are shaped like bulbs. I ended up adding some sprinkles that I did not purchase from Dollar Tree, because the Dollar Tree sprinkles, since they are small crystal kinds, you're gonna need quite a few packs to fill up this, so it's cheaper for me to go to the grocery store and get the more chunky sprinkles. That doesn't mean I didn't add the sugar crystals to this basket. I did, I just left them inside of the packaging. Now I'm gonna use these cute elf picks from Dollar Tree. They look like elf legs, and I'm gonna place those inside of my basket. Off camera, I placed a pick inside of the basket, and that was it. This is another nice basket to give to anybody, honestly, that you know. I purchased this black and white basket from Dollar Tree, and I'm gonna fill it up with some red decorative shred. Dollar Tree has a bunch of pretty travel mugs. I'm gonna place one of these candy cane ones inside of my basket. Then I'm gonna throw in these cookies. I'm also gonna add two of these gigantic candy cane sticks that are also from Dollar Tree. Dollar Tree has hot chocolate bombs right now, so I'm gonna place one of those inside of this gift basket. I wanna add some marshmallows to this basket, so I got this container from Dollar Tree and I placed some marshmallows inside of there. I then put that inside of the gift basket. I throw in some cinnamon sugar, and as a little embellishment, I got this gingerbread ornament from Dollar Tree. I removed the picture and drew the face of a gingerbread man on this and placed that inside of the basket. I threw in some of those elf leg picks and a bottled brush Christmas tree. To the front, I placed this pretty bow that I got from Dollar Tree. I had to use some of the glue dots to get it to stick to the basket. I then placed some of that green ribbon from Dollar Tree inside of the basket, and that's it. I feel like this basket is good for anybody, especially people like coworkers or acquaintances, teachers. This is more of like a gift idea than a gift basket. You're gonna get some mugs from Dollar Tree. I love the ones that they carry. And you're gonna get a packet of hot chocolate. Right now they have these Nestle packets that say cocoa for you on the front. They're perfect for this. So you're gonna go ahead, bend the bottom, and stick that inside of your mug. Now I got these loop bags from Dollar Tree that come in a 40 pack, and I'm gonna fill some of these up with some marshmallows that I'm also gonna throw inside of my mug. It's an easy gift idea. Right now you can find a bunch of things like this already done at like Five Below. If you make it yourself, you can do a bunch of them for cheaper because you have the loop bags and a bigger bag of marshmallows. And to cut costs down more, you can get the 6-pack of Swiss Miss hot chocolate from Dollar Tree and use those instead of the single packs of Nestle hot cocoa. Our final gift basket is just to show you guys that Dollar Tree carries name brand stuff. I was able to make a Pixar basket of sorts. I got a jumbo coloring book that is Toy Story themed and a Toy Story book, and it's actually Toy Story 1 that book consists of. I'm gonna throw in some Toy Story puzzles. I really like the Dollar Tree puzzles. Yeah, sometimes they can be thin, but they're great for the price, especially for children. They also have a bunch of Pixar figurines. These ones you see right here are new. They always carry Toy Story. They always carry Monsters, Inc. They have new ones that include Miguel from Coco. I put some of those elf legs inside of this basket to just jazz it up a bit. This basket with the elf legs cost me $11 to make.